Hello. I have bought some Formula One parts from the new turbo era, which is, I think, very amazing to be able to get some of these parts. It's hard to find, but it was the auction in a couple of months ago because of the Manor F1 team in England. They went bankruptcy. So between 2016 and 17 season. So that's why I was able to get some parts, very nice parts, sensors, oil tank, piping, boxes with various parts, exhaust, and some wiring harnesses, cockpit wire harness. I think I can show you in this video this intercooler. It's a Ferrari, for the Ferrari engine, and some of the wastegates. Interesting to see how the wastegates in the modern Formula One cars. So let's first look at this intercooler. Very special. Yes, this is the intercooler from what I believe is the 2014. I think they were Marrusia team at the time, and the engine was a Ferrari engine. So it was the exact same unit, I think, was used in the Ferraris. And as you can see here, installed on the car, so I can see that it actually is the same part that is used in the race cars. And I think it's very similar to the, they used this 2014 and 15. And it's a liquid cooled intercooler. It's interesting to see how the different engine manufacturers uses different intercoolers. I think Mercedes uses the more traditional air-to-air intercoolers, and this is liquid-to-air intercooler. And the first thing that caught my attention here is that they're using silicone couplings. And normal worm clamps. It's ABBA stainless, ABA stainless. What I think is a Swedish company, I'm not sure. And the hoses are Samco Extreme. It's from England, I believe. And the ones with the bulb, I don't know if that's the correct word for it, but so I thought everything in Formula One car was Wiggins type or hydroflow couplings, but no, it's not. It's not. So that's interesting to see. And as you can see in a picture of the real car, it's the same they used on the cars. So this is not any testing unit or some mock-up or something like that. It's the real deal. This intercooler is installed in the V of the engine. So the air from the turbo was behind the engine, the air from the turbo went in here, and this was in the V. This is towards the driver of the car, the fuel tank, and then the driver. So it's the front one, and then you have these ductings goes to the intake on the left hand and right hand side of the intercooler. So this is the flange for intake. It's a very nice machine flange that is bonded into this, it's carbon fiber ducting. And as you can see, the finish of the ducting on the outside is not very, very nice. But if you can feel and see on the inside, it's very smooth and nice. So I believe this is really strong and lightweight. But the finish on the outside, it's not perfect, but it's the inside that is the most important thing. And it's a very, very nice piece of engineering and machining. You can see the it's machined aluminum, I guess, and carbon fiber. I think it's very special inside as well. I'm going to open it up and see how it looks like, what kind of technique they're using in the intercoolers of the modern era F1s. And just to feel it, it's, you can really feel it's very, very thin. It's machined these ribs to make it strong, and it's very, very thin, these parts. It has some connections for sensors. I have some of these turbo sensor, pressure, temp sensors over there. I can show you them in a later video. And I'm absolutely not an expert on these Formula One parts and engines, but I want to learn more and see what they use, because it's very interesting, and they're very secret about what's used in the parts, and yeah, it's very high tech, and hopefully can use it for my own cars. Actually, my plan was to buy two of these. Now that didn't go well. I just got one of them, and my plan was to put on my Lamborghini there. That's twin turbo. Plan was to put two of these intercoolers, because these was made for maybe 800 horsepower each. Yeah, the engine was output was 800 horsepower, but my plan is to have more than 800 horsepower, so maybe I need to have two of them. And as you can see, the inlet here, it's I think they maybe do this for packaging to make it small, but also it's I think it is to keep the velocity of the air at a constant speed, so you don't have like a normal car intercooler. Usually it was like a big cone here, so it will make the velocity go down. Okay, I will open this up and let's see how it looks on the inside.
What?
Okay, I have now taken it apart somehow, and as you can see, it's not like normal intercoolers with bars and fins. It's many, many small pipes. I remove this, and you can see here is the inlet for the coolant. The air goes here, comes out here, and yeah, in from this side and out here, and from the top here it is, it's possible to see these small holes. Actually counted how many it is on all this, it was 16,000. So 16, one of these intercoolers, it is 16,000 of these small pipes, tubes maybe you say it. So I'm not sure what this kind of intercooler, what's this type is called, so I have to check it out. Or if anybody know here, you can just comment and say what kind of intercooler type this is. But it's very nice. Remove this. Yeah, it's a nice machine, the piece. Very lightweight, very thin. You see here on the inside, they have been sanded by hand, so it's even a little bit smoother. It's very nice. It's O-ring around there, and the connection fitting. It's not very big connections here, Not very big. As I can understand, the fluid goes through this intercooler four times. This is inlet or outlet, or this is the inlet or outlet. Goes in here, goes down one time, and then you can see on the side, it's no connections there, so it goes from one side up again. Here is it big again, fluid goes down and up again. And there is some very small in the middle here, connector, one here as well, that I believe is for bleeding, maybe. But yeah, it's cool. The fluid goes four times through this. Usually all the liquid to air intercoolers I've seen before, the fluid only goes through one time. But yeah, many other radiators I've seen goes, can be dual pass, goes to through two times. This is four times. So I removed the bottom as well here, and also I was thinking what kind of fluid there is. It's still wet, so, and it feels like some kind of, I've not tasted it, but some kind of water, very water. I don't know what the rules say, if they must have some water based fluid. So can see if I turn it on the side, you can see it's actually leaking. Yeah, it looks very much like water. And here you can see many of these holes, again thousands, 16,000 of these holes. So yeah, never seen that before in an intercooler, but yeah, maybe they use it in some other applications as well. And here you can see there is no connection, so the water must go from one side, changes direction and goes up again. So that must be how it's working. And here you can see also the bushings for, it's not like a rubber bushing, it's more like a metal kind of bushing, so it's takes the vibrations. What I believe, there can be a lot of vibrations in this kind of engines, especially now when they have this pre-ignition engines. So that's what Honda had problems with now, and yeah, probably other manufacturers as well, with the vibrations. Okay, I think that's it on the intercooler. Yeah, you can see here also the inside of this duct, carbon fiber duct. It has all the part numbers, but it doesn't say who's the manufacturer of these parts. But yeah, it's very smooth on the inside, outside. Yeah, you've seen before. Okay, next thing I can show you are these wastegates. I have actually, I had three of them. It's the same engine, 2014, I think maybe 15, they used them as well. It's a butterfly wastegate. I take it up. Okay, here is a wastegate of modern Formula One car, new era, turbo era Formula One car. And this is from the Ferrari engine, and it was used in the Marrusia Manor team. And as you can see, it's a butterfly type wastegate, not like a poppet style, like it's used in normal turbo cars. And I see other manufacturers, engine manufacturers in Formula One, they use the poppet style valve, but they use the, I'm not sure if they use this style anymore, but maybe they still do. And also you can see here, it's a carbon fiber cooling ducts, because the actuator of this one is cooled. So let's, okay, just remove this carbon fiber. Very lightweight, and you can see it's handles the heat pretty well. Here you can see the butterfly style wastegate. This is the outlet that goes to the, this year the wastegate went into the normal exhaust. Then they changed the rules to get some more noise of the cars, so the wastegate went have separate pipes out, but here it went back to the exhaust. And the inside, you can see they are separate from one is from the left hand bank and one is from the right hand bank. And also this one is very nice machined. I don't know what kind of material it's made of, would be interesting to see, but yeah, probably something exotic. And here on the brackets, maybe you can see the Ferrari horse. There it is. Not the best. Yeah, there's the Ferrari horse, and there is some part number on it. Very nice bracket here as well. And some heat shielding over the valve. And the actuator of this one is here on the top. It's a small hydraulic actuator, so it's not like with the air pressure, turbo pressure that's in the normal cars. It's hydraulic. So these are the two hydraulic lines. It goes here with heat shielding, and it's very small. Everything is everything is very small. And on this one as well, maybe you can see. It says Ferrari on there, and the part number. It's a very, very nice piece of machined actuator. And output goes to this rod, to the lever that actuates the wastegate. Very simple design, actually. Very simple design. And it has a connector also here on the that goes into it's a 5-pin connector, Deutsch Autosport miniature connector, very small one. It goes in, so I guess it's a position sensor inside of this, so they can know exact the position of the wastegate. So actually a very simple design, and I bet it's working good. Not sure if Ferrari still uses this kind of design, but for the 2014 and 15 I think they did. It's cool, as you can see here, this comes, the air comes from the roll hop, the car goes in, and some of the cooling is here for the actuator, hydraulic actuator, wastegate actuator, and then it goes down to cool something else. I'm not sure what it's cooling. Cond cooling G, ceramica, it says. And it looks a little bit ugly here. Some filter there as well. Yeah, that's it. I had another one. Actually, I have two more. But this is another one. You can see here, it has been... the heat shielding is not as nice anymore. So these suffer really, really hard from driving. And this heat shield here, it's a little bit broken. And then you can see in the carbon fiber, it's... it has been seen a lot more heat than the other one. They don't live easy life, these parts. You can see here also the very nice actuator. It's a nice machine. And yeah, what should I do with this? First, I don't know what if I should use them, maybe. It's very interesting to see what kind of technique they are using, what kind of parts they are using for the modern Formula One cars. Some of these parts I will use on my cars, my project cars. Maybe this wastegate I will put on my old Volvo 75 with 2J. Would be cool. I don't know. Let's see. Yeah, I hope you liked the video. If you like it, and I can show you some more of the parts from the new Formula One cars. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.